Good evening, viewers, and welcome to another episode of Catch Play. We're coming to you from the Tauroma Aquatic Indoor Center. Behind me and beside me, we've got basketball and volleyball training underway at the moment. But it's always a great pleasure to have Godwin on the show.
Well, it's always a pleasure to have you on the show, Mai, to keep me company for the half hour of the show.
Well, Godwin, we've got some great lineup for tonight.
That's right, we do have an interesting lineup for you viewers tonight. Now, obviously, we have our 2-minute highlight at the start of the show, the 2016 emblem for the Team PNG, Baikis team preparation for 2016, Ryan Pini. And finally, we have the 2-minute challenge, Mai, with Ryan Pini. Obviously, we gave our viewers a little bit of a sneak peek last week, but I'm sure they're in for a real treat tonight.
What an exciting lineup, especially the 2-minute challenge between Godwin and Ryan Pini. That will be exciting to watch. So, you know, viewers, don't go anywhere. But without further ado, let's take a look at the highlights with Godwin.
Welcome to stories making headlines on internet and social media. The swimming national championships ended over the weekend after a 3-day of competition. Now, swimmers from Leigh and Port Moresby took part to qualify for the national side that saw the event take place at the Tauroma Aquatic Centre in Port Moresby. And Papua New Guinea's 28-year-old professional boxer Douglas Wallo has introduced boxing to youths in one of Leigh's notorious settlements, West Taraka, where he aims to keep youths away from illegal activities to lure them into a boxing career. Papua New Guinea's current record holder for the 200 metres, the Pacific Games gold medalist Nelson Stone, has set sight for Rio Olympics with confidence to set standards. However, Stone's current focus is on the 78th Singapore Open Track and Field Championships, which will be held from the 28th to the 29th of this month at the Singapore Sports Hub. And SB Hunters halfback Ase Boas says he has drastically improved over the past few years in his playing style as halfback. And meanwhile, PNG's Rugby League Football Chief Executive Officer Bob Cutmore has confirmed the playing days of the SB Hunters' remaining home games at the National Football Stadium in Port Moresby. Cutmore says the dates and the days have been confirmed with the Queensland Rugby League. And now to stories overseas, and Auckland City will take on some of the best players of the planet yet again at December's FIFA Club World Cup after lifting the OFC Champions League trophy for the groundbreaking sixth consecutive time. And Hawaiian Sebastian Zietz has captured the stoke of his shock win at the Margaret River Pro with some classic surf lingo after being told he was ranked number 2 in the world. And 4 stadiums will be used during the FIFA Under-20 Women's World Cup in November. Chief Executive Officer of the Under-20 Local Organising Committee, Seamus Martin, says construction and upgrade of the venues is yet to start. On 7 April, Rio de Janeiro City has unveiled an important element of the Rio 2016 legacy, the new Marina da Gloria, the marina which will host the sailing events at the Olympic and Paralympic Games. And Alistair Clarkson has officially ended speculations about his AFL future by re-signing with the Hawthorn Club.
Take us through for the segment for tonight.
That's right. Now, our first story for this evening is the unveiling of the 2016 emblem for Team PNG. So let's have a look.
The PNG Olympics Committee celebrated 100 days marked before the start of the 2016 Summer Olympic Games. The event also coincided with the launch of the new emblems at the Ella Beach Hotel. Partners, representatives of national federations and Team PNG athletes were there to unveil its latest emblem. Over the years, the PNG Olympic Committee has changed its emblems to suit the changing times and the roles and responsibilities it holds. An emblem is everything to an organization. It is not just an image, it gives the organization its identity and stands for its values. This means the organization has 4 different emblems, one for each games and one for Team PNG. In the past, each emblem had its own design. However, all emblems have been redeveloped to capture the purpose of the organization while at the same time maintaining their identity for each of the movement. PNG Olympic Committee's Secretary General, Mrs. Ovita Rapila, said that there needs to be consistency in their emblems so there is no confusion every time they use one of their logos for the games. The new emblem features a stylish version of the Bird of Paradise, Papua New Guinea's national symbol, and the colors of the country's national flag. It seems the Bird of Paradise, or Kumul, connected with most famous of symbols in the sporting world, the Olympic greens, which was approved recently by International Olympic Committee.
Yes, and there you have it. That was the unveiling of the 2016 Team PNG's emblem for this year's Rio Olympic Games. And you might tell us a brief information about the unveiling, because you were there to cover the story.
Well, Papua New Guinea Olympic Committee were there at Ella Beach Hotel. They also marked the 100 days to go for the Rio Olympics. Yeah, the countdown to the Rio Olympic Games. And at the same time, they unveiled their new emblem for Team PNG to the Rio Olympics. You know, it's been a long time. After so long, they've come up with a new emblem where, you know, when they represent the country, they will have people to recognize that emblem and say that's Team PNG. So
right.
They know that this Papua New Guinea Bird of Paradise represents PNG during the competitions they're having outside of Papua New Guinea.
So just before we go for a quick break, tell us about just the emblem itself. What's the significance behind it? Obviously, I'm sure many people would have questioned why they chose. There should be a process as to how they chose the emblem.
Well, it is the Bird of Paradise, the PNG Bird of Paradise, and they used four colors actually on the PNG, the flag to color in the Bird of Paradise. So that will be the emblem for PNG to the Rio Olympic Games.
Wow. Well, good on the PNG Olympics Committee for coming up with the new emblem for 2016's Rio Olympics for Team PNG. Otherwise, we'll take a quick break, Mai, and we'll see you after this. Watching Catch Play. Now we're coming to you from the Tarama Aquatic Center Indoor Sports Complex. Now our next story for this evening is the Baikis athletics team preparations for the upcoming Gulf Province athletics tournament. So why don't we have a look?
Since the inception of the Baikis athletics team last year, we caught up with the team and their coach, former PNG rep, Queen of Athletics, Mai Koime, who still holds the record for women's 100 meters in the country. Mai and her athletes have started their training sessions at the Marabarik's Oval in preparations for the upcoming athletics tournament in Kerama Gulf Province that will take place next month.
The championships will be held in Malalawa Secondary School, so you know it's a great privilege for my team, who started last year 2015 during the Southern Region Championships. So you know the team is looking really good. The boys and girls have been training and looking forward for the competition.
One of her fastest and upcoming roadrunner, Noah Sambabe, who holds the title as the third runner-up for Port Moresby, said he is happy with the strength and conditioning training and is looking forward to the Gulf Championships.
I was playing road runner. I feel like I happy to run road runner, road run.
Yes.
This is like I get fitness to run the event like 400, 200. I run distance. I get benefit of them, of this road run. Okay. I am very happy to see that my team Baikis, like this is our golf, but team so. I'm so happy to join Baikis athletics team.
Okay. His counterpart and fellow athlete also shared similar thoughts in regards to his training and how much of improvements and results they have been going through since their training sessions with Mai Koime.
Yes, and there you have it. That was the Baikis club and enthusiastic team out there training in preparations for their upcoming tournament. Now, Mai, obviously I caught up with you and your team. Great bunch of kids. Tell us about the preparations.
Well, look, Baikis is a new team. This is into their almost going into 1 year now, and we've been invited to take part in the Gulf Games next month. So the kids have been really excited about traveling and competing with other Gulf athletes up in Malalawa. Yep. And this is to pick the team for the PNG Games for Gulf team. So everyone's all excited and, you know, they're looking forward to this competition.
How do you think your team's going?
You know, I know my team's going to do well. So, I've been talking to them, giving them all the advice they can. Coming from me as a former athlete myself, I've given them the tips and just told them to concentrate and focus on their training preparations and see what the outcome is when they get there.
Now, just before we go for a quick break, obviously you guys have been training in different areas around Port Moresby. Is there any particular reason why you're doing that?
Look, last year we've been training at the Four Square church grounds, but because, you know, athletics needs the bigger space for training, and the church itself does not, you know, have that kind of space for my athletes to train. So we looked at the Murray Barracks Oval, which has a bigger space so that the athletes are currently training there. And there's, a lot of sports that are happening there as well, and it encourages them as well.
Now, just quickly, if anyone's interested in joining the club, are they more than welcome to join?
Look, if you're interested in joining the club, you're more than welcome. We're currently training at the Murray Barracks Oval at the moment.
Thank you very much, Ma. What an interesting story, and all the best to your team.
Thank you very much, and I think we should go for a break.
Yes, we should. We'll take a quick break, and up next we have the man himself, Ryan Pini.
Moments I make, moments I remind, moments I take.
Selfies in the background.
Selfie in the background.
With less than 100 days to go before the 2016 Olympic Games, PNG's golden fish Ryan Pini has set eyes on Rio this time around. Ryan, who is currently training both in the country and overseas in preparations for his Rio Olympic Games, Ryan has been focusing more on his strengths, especially his backstrokes, 50-meter freestyle, butterfly and backstroke. Recently competing in the Australian Swimming Championships in Adelaide last month, Ryan was happy with the result of his performances, where he also managed to win gold in one of his fastest and best stroke 50-meter butterfly, which was also his first ever gold medal to be won at the Hancock Prospecting Swimming Championships. He said winning gold at the Australian Swimming Championships has given him the boost of confidence and an encouragement to do more training in preparations for the Olympic Games, but rather more of an achievement for himself.
Personal best time. Things are going very well, especially in the 50s, with a bit more training. 99 days to go now, or 100 days to go. Got some good amount of time to be able to push myself harder.
Ryan will continue his training in preparations for the Oceania Championships. Meanwhile, he said swimmers based in the country and overseas have stepped up and are doing great in the pool, where some swimmers broke their personal best records since the Pacific Games, and also in the recent TODs Championships in Port Moresby. Right now, all swimmers both overseas-based and in the country are in training in preparations for the Oceania Swimming Championships.
You have it, that was the interview between Ryan Pini and Godwin Aki. Godwin, interview between Ryan and his preparations. Tell us a bit about that.
Look, Ryan, he's an absolute legend, an absolute hero to all Papua New Guineans. Obviously a role model to all of us. Now, his preparations, recently he did attend the Australian Swimming Championships in Adelaide, where he did really well. He was happy with his results. He won gold in one of his best strokes, which is a 50-meter butterfly. And he said it was quite an achievement for him. And then after that event, he did attend the TODs Championships that took place here in Port Moresby. And his comments towards the other swimmers was that he's seen great improvement in swimming since the recent Pacific Games. Some of the swimmers have broken their personal best records, and the TODs Championships was no different. And now all the swimmers are in training for the Oceania Championships before they can all attend the big games in Rio.
Well, what a great interview and a great story for Ryan. All the best to his preparations for the Rio Olympics.
So Ryan, he's really looking forward to the Olympic Games. His family is going to be there too. They've all bought tickets to go and watch the games. So he's really excited. And so to all Papua New Guineans, please just tune in. And I'm sure It will be telecast live around the country, and let's all get out there and support our Team PNG.
Anyway, Godwin loves his swimming, so we're going to go for a quick break. But don't go anywhere. Stay watching, because we've got the 2-minute challenge, swimming challenge.
We're going to get wild.
Welcome to another edition of The Challenger here on Catch Play. I'm your host for this particular challenge, Judah Mamafu, and this time Godwin's going to be taking on someone special. So, someone special in terms of swimming PNG, but Ryan Pini is going to be up against Godwin Eki, and we're going to see who's going to come out on top for the 50 meter, what is it, freestyle? Freestyle, am I right? Freestyle. Freestyle challenge. Ryan, how are you feeling?
Yeah, a little bit nervous actually. I'm not too sure what to expect from Godwin. He's a good challenge in the pool back a few years ago, so we'll see how we go.
All right, have you done something like this before?
No, this will be the first time, so pretty eager to get in and give it a go.
This is your second challenge for our challenge episode thingy. How do you feel like getting into this one?
It's been a while since I was in the pool. Yes, I know I'm going against Ryan Pini, who's obviously the fastest swimmer in Papua New Guinea.
And the Pacific,
yes, that's right. It's going to be a big challenge for me. I mean, I've seen him during the Pacific Games swim, and maybe it's all the camera tricks that we've seen on TV.
Oh, right.
But I can't wait to see who wins this challenge.
You got a good feeling about this?
I'm feeling good, especially, going up against my role model. And I'm just so excited about this challenge.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. This is Godwin Eki up against Ryan Pini. This should be awesome.
Oh my God!
I feel my heart.
This is the day of reckoning. Godwin up against Ryan Pini. All right, guys, are we ready? On your mark.
All right, Godwin's about to start swimming.
Hey, go, Godwin!
And they're off. Godwin lost.
Bit disappointed I lost to Ryan, but it was a good challenge. I'm just glad I did this race with Ryan.
So how are you feeling? You think you're going to take up more swimming lessons after this?
Probably, yeah. Maybe every now and then I'll come and have a swim in the pool. Otherwise, swimming will always be part of who I am. Well, not competitively, but I'll be there to support my fellow swimmers. Otherwise, swimming is a good exercise. Yeah.
Well, I just like to say, Godwin, you sucked.
You really think I suck?
Okay. That's funny.
But well done, Godwin.
I got drunk.
Well done for sucking.
Thank you.
All right, awesome stuff. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for this week's edition of The Challenger. And Godwin up against Ryan, unfortunately, didn't end too well for Godwin. But hopefully next week's challenge, we don't know what might happen. So you have to tune into next week's episode of Catch Play and find out what the challenge is. But from us to you, it's back to the studios, back to Godwin and Mai again. Back to we got some crazy fans.
That was the 2-minute challenge between Ryan and Godwin. Godwin, what happened there? We've been getting trashed in basketball and now swimming. What was it like?
Well, Mai, obviously, firstly, I just want to say I was so excited to be
going up against my role model Ryan Pini. It was a great challenge, obviously one way of seeing where my fitness levels are. I've said this the first challenge, I'm saying it again, but I wasn't that far. I wasn't that far from Ryan. I was this close to Ryan, and I nearly got to the finish line, but he got the line first.
It was close to, very you know, close. To see that yourself and Ryan competing after 2 years.
Yes.
He said that you've been in the pool for a while.
Yes.
Look, we're athletes ourselves, and we've been getting trashed by these, you know, top athletes. But you know, it's all a mind power thing. So I know Godwin will is getting over that, and without that, you know, he's excited that he swam with Ryan himself.
Yeah, I mean, he was so loosened up, you know, in the swimming pool and doing the interview as well that we've seen earlier on the show, doing the interview on the pool. He was so relaxed. So it was just so comfortable, and I think the challenge obviously was quite a good one.
Well, great to have the challenge again. We've got more challenges coming up, Godwin, so I think we've come to the end of the show.
Yeah, well, the 2 minute challenge has obviously brought us to the end of this show. Otherwise, you know, if you've missed out on last week's episode and this week, you can always catch us. Go to MTV's website, you can find us online, go to programs, catch play. Or if you have any queries, you can always send us an email to sports@mtv.com.pg, or you can visit Michael Mann, myself, at the Boroko
Garden
City Level 2, and we'll be more than happy to help you out. Otherwise, a very special thank you to Tarama Aquatic Center for allowing us to use
their
facility. Gus and his team, a big thank you to you.
Synchronized.